I'm going to teach you how to prove global warming. You'll be able to prove it to yourself, your friends, your family, your neighbors, your enemies. You won't need any science or studies or numbers or anything like that. All you have to do is take your shoes off, walk around on a hot summer day. You will realize you can stand on green grass for as long as you like. Not a problem. What you cannot do is stand on a black asphalt road. It's too hot. There are laws in cities that say you're not allowed to walk your dog during a heat advisory because the road can get so hot, it will literally burn their paws and injure them. If you want to heat something up, paint it black. Put your food in a black box, the sun will cook it for you. Put your water in a black hose, the sun will turn it into hot water. The sun does not just heat up the road, it heats up everything under the road. All the dirt, the germs, the bacteria, the mycelium, the roots of the plants, literally turning the earth into a solar oven. The scientists deceive you. They hold up a thermometer and say, oh look, the temperature hasn't changed. No, 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 that's the air. The earth is under your feet. Take your shoes off and you can literally feel the earth getting warmer. It is not possible to look out over an area as large as a Walmart parking lot and tell me that painting something that big from green grass to black rock will not heat it up. Of course it's getting hotter. It defies all common sense logic and reasoning. Not only is the rock getting hotter in the summer, it gets colder in the winter. From one extreme to the next, hotter summers, colder winters, climate change. They want you to believe it's easier to go to Walmart and buy food than it is to grow your own. Why should my food be grown in California, shipped across the country in a diesel-powered truck, rotting in plastic bags, cardboard boxes, all the energy and labor required to take the food from the farm to the truck to the warehouse, delivered to the store? Somebody has to be paid to throw it in the dumpster when it expires. I would have had to have a job first so I can buy the food, and I got to carry it home in those little plastic bags that hurt my fingers. And what universe is that easier than walking to my front door and picking a fig off the tree? It's not. They are lying to you. The farmer is lying to you. The grocer is lying to you. The school lied to you. Your government is lying to you. The scientists are lying to you. They want you to believe the earth is a dead rock spinning around the sun. No, it's not. The earth is a living creature. The earth is alive. The creation has its own intelligence. They want you to believe it's always been this way. That's not true. 100 years ago, the automobile had barely been invented and there were virtually no roads painted black anywhere on this entire planet. 100 years ago, there was absolutely no plastic polluting our environment anywhere. Today, there are mountains of plastic larger than some countries floating around our oceans. 100 years ago, there was no man-made nuclear radiation anywhere. Today, the entire planet is contaminated with radiation from Fukushima, Chernobyl, Three Mile Island, and who knows how many secret tests the militaries have been conducted. 100 years ago, the sun and the wind really did dry our clothes and without polluting our drinking water with coal ash. They want you to believe it's always been this way? No, it has never been this way. Thousands upon thousands of years of human history, the earth has never been this polluted before, ever. It was my friend Little Hawk that told me the Native American prophecy of the Rainbow People that says in the last days, when the earth is ravaged and dying, a new tribe of people shall rise up out of the ashes. Made up of all colors, classes, and creeds, they will make the earth green again and be called the Warriors of the Rainbow. When this land was given to me, it was just dirt. The only thing that grew here was sand and stickers. I planted the grass, I planted the fig tree, a peach tree, pear tree, apricot tree, olive tree, hazelnut tree, plum tree, lemon tree, orange tree, banana tree, avocado tree, mulberry tree. I am Warrior of the Rainbow. I took a barren desert wasteland and turned it into a tropical paradise, and I am not done. The day is coming where I'm going to turn that dead black road in front of my house back into living green grass that breathes. I'm going to go to Walmart, punch holes in the asphalt parking lot, plant fruit trees. I'm going to turn Walmart into a food forest where people go to find food, not buy food. I'm going to turn the city of North Myrtle Beach into the garden of North Myrtle Beach. The city of Atlanta into the garden of Atlanta. The city of New York into the garden of New York. The garden of Florida. The garden of Los Angeles. The garden of America, where you walk out your front door and find food growing in every direction, where it is not possible for any creature to go hungry because there is an abundance of food growing free everywhere. The first page of the Bible is about a garden. The last page of the Bible is about a garden. If that's not enough for you, Jesus did not go to the temple to pray. He went to the garden to pray. The way to a man's heart is through his stomach. The way to God's heart is through his garden. God did not build a grocery store. He created a garden. And the day is coming where we will replant that garden. This is Joe signing out from Base Camp Zero, Zero. It is a word, not a number.